गुड मॉर्निंग बहन। हाँ मैं ऑडिबल। यस हाँ मैं ऑडिबल। Is the screen is visible? Okay, answer your attendance in the chat box using three parameters. Okay, once again, good morning. This is the video lecture on design and analysis of algorithms. So we are currently discussing with the module 3, the greedy method. So today in the previous class, we have seen with the minimum cost spanning tree. So minimum cost spanning tree using Kruskal algorithm. So in today's class, we are going to see very, very important topic. Single source shortest path using Dijkstra's algorithm. So what's the concept name? It is single source. So from one source, you have to find shortest path using Dijkstra's algorithm. Okay, so that we shall see. It's very, very important from exam point of view. So I'm telling you, it's very, very important from exam point of view. So first, before going into the algorithm, let's see what's the problem statement. Okay, so given a graph and a source vertex. Okay, so you are given a graph and a source vertex in the graph. So find the shortest path from source to all the vertices in the graph. So you have to find the shortest path from source. So source can be A, whatever. So any node, we call it as a source to all the vertices in the given graph. So you have to find the shortest path from source to all vertices in the given graph. So for that, which is the best algorithm? Dijkstra's algorithm is the best known algorithm. It is similar to Prim's algorithm. This is applicable to undirected and directed graphs with non-negative weights. Okay, so understand here. So it is similar to Prim's algorithm, but it is applicable to undirected and directed graphs with non-negative weights. So non-negative means positive weights only. Okay, so now you come for the working of that particular Dijkstra's. First, it finds the shortest path from source. Shortest path from source to the vertex nearest to it, then to the second nearest, and so on. So find the shortest path from source. So okay, you have to keep in your mind, here you are calculating the distance from source to all other remaining vertices. So this is the statement you have to keep in your mind. So from the source to all the remaining vertices, you have to find the shortest path from source to the vertex nearest to it, then to the second nearest, and so on. So before its ith iteration commences, the algorithm has already identified the shortest path to i minus one other vertices nearest to source. That we shall see what this statement is going to tell in our example. So this is the algorithm we have taken. So what is the, this is the diagram what we have taken. So here source node is 0, destination node is 4. Keep in your mind. So this is at one less. So source node is 0 and destination last node is 4. Okay. So you have to. So for that, you have to find the distance from source to destination. So from source to all other nodes using minimum weights. Okay. So using minimum weights, first you start with 0. Okay. As you start with 0, so 0, which are the paths you are having? 0 to 1 is 4, 0 to 7 is 8. So for now, we take it as 0 to, you keep on doing this one, you will easily understand. So 0 to 1, it is 4, 0 to 7, it is 8. So that's why you are written 0 to 1, it is path is, weight is 4, 0 to 7, weight is 8. Okay, so in that, which is the nearest vertex you are having? So can you tell which is the nearest vertex from 0 to 1 or 0 to 8? Which is the nearest vertex from 0? Which is nearest to 0? Okay, so it is 1 because its path is how much? So its path is 4. So that's why you take it as. So here you can see. So this is first level. Second level, 1 is marked as visited. So 0 to 1, it is 4. Okay, so from 4. So come for 1. Okay, so coming for 1, which are the vertices you are having? 1 to 0. 1 to 2, 1 to 7. So for node vertex, this one, so which is the nearest one you have to tell. So from 1, this is at 4, this is at 8, this is at 4, this is at 11. So which is the shortest one? So which is nearest to 1 you have to tell. Which is nearest to 1? But 1 to 0, path is already done. Okay, so you are telling from node 1, so 1 to 0, it's already, the path has been existed. After that, what is the next node you are having? So after that, next node is 2, because after 4, 8 is there, 11 is there. In that 8 is minimum 1. So for now you have to take the total path from 0. So total path from 0 you have to find. From 0 to 1 is finished. From 0 to 2. So from 0 to 2, what is the path you are having? 4 plus 8. So 4 plus 8, you take it as 12. Okay. Understanding? So you have to find the path from source to all the remaining nodes. Okay, so that's why 0 to 1, it is 4. 1 to 2, it is 8. So 0 to 2, so it is 4 plus 8 that we given it as 12. Understanding? So after that, now you come for the next one. So after 4, this is at 12, this is at 8. So will you go for 12 or you come with 8? So to come for the lesser one. So 0 to 7. So 0 to 7, it is the lesser path. So that's why you are going directly 0 to 7 as path is been connected here. Understood? So 0 to 7, it's 8. Now this is at 12. So now here you should see from 7, which are the nodes you can connect? From 7, which are the nodes you can connect? So 7 to 1. 1 has been already been noted, so don't go for 1. 1 already lagogide, so you are not taking 1. So after 0, 7 to 1 is there, 7 to 0 is there, 7 to 6 is there, 7 to 8 is there. So in that, 1 and 0 is already finished. So what are there in green, that thing is already finished. Now you come for 7, which is the nearest one. So 7 to 6, 7, which is the nearest path, 7 to 6, it's 1. Okay, so which is the nearest? So what is for seven? So it is six with a weight one. So what is the path you are having from the source you have to take? So 8 plus 1, it is equal to 9. Understanding? So 8 plus this thing, it is 9. So what is now, which node is marked? So 6 is marked. So after 6, which is the next one you are having? Here you have 12. So here you can see. So come to, from to, you can also visit this one. What will be the path? So now this is the shortest path you are having. So from 0 to 7, it's already marked. So after 1, so you have 7 is there, 8 is there. 8 is already marked. So remaining is 7. So 8 plus 7. So 8 plus 7, you mark it as 15. Okay, so that's why we are telling 0 to 7, it's 8. 7 to 8, it's 7. So 8 plus 7 is 15. So this is the vertex which one you can visit. Understanding? So after this, so which are the marks nodes which are visited? 0 visited, 1 visited, 7 is marked, 6 is marked, 8 is marked. Okay, so 8 it is 15, but 8 it is 15, but when you go through this part, what is the cost? So 8 can be visited through 0, or you can also visit through this part. So if you go through this part, what will be the cost? 4 plus 8 plus 2. So cost will be 14. But if you go through this part, how much will be the cost? It is 15. So 14, if you go through 2, it is 14. If you go through 7, it is 15. So which one you will take? So for node 8, so understand carefully, for node 8, if you visit through 7, the path is 8 plus 7, 15. But if you go through 2, 4 plus 8 is 12, 12 plus 2 is 14. So which one you are going to take? So whether you go with 15 or you go with 14? 15 or 14, which one you will go? So for node 8, you keep in your mind, if you go through 7 path, so 8 plus 7, it is coming under 15. If you go through this part, 4 plus 8 plus 2, so 10 plus 4, 14. So which one you are going to take? So you go with 15 or 14? Yes, answer in the chat box. So it is 14. So here it is marked as 15, but you can see here, so it is at 15, so you are not going to take it. You will be marking this one as 14 here. So this is the shortest path you are having. So from 2 it is there, from 2 it is going to 14. So 2 is visited, 8 is visited, 6 is visited. Now 5 has not came. So which are the edges you can connect to 5 from source? So 4 plus 8 plus 4. So what is the cost you have? 4 plus 8 plus 4 or 8 plus 1 plus 2. So which one you will be taking from 0 to 5? Which are the paths? So type in the chat box, from 0 to 5, so which are the paths you are having? So which path and what is the cost? So how many paths you are having? From 0 to 5, you can travel using 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 5. Or you can also go through 0 to 7, 7 to 6, 7 to 5. So which is the, so this path will go 8 plus 4 plus 8 plus 4. What is the cost you have? So 8 plus 8, it is 16. But when you go through this part, so 8 plus 1 plus 2. So what is the cost? It is 11. So that's why you can take it. So this one, 5 is marked as 11. So now after this, which is the last node you have? 4. So how the four can be visited? So four can be visited using 8 plus 1 plus 2 plus 10, or you can go with 4 plus 8 plus 7 plus 9. So you have so many paths. So in that, which one you can go? So kindly tell me the path from 0 to 4. 0 to 4, which are the paths? Yes, reply in the chat box, which are the paths you are having from 0 to 4? So which are the paths we have in 0 to 4? Zero to one, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. And the other one is 0 to 7, 7 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 4. So in that, which is the minimum cost you are having? Minimum cost is 0 to 7, 7 to 6, 6 to 5, and 5 to 4. So path is, so how much you are having? So 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 10, 20, 21 is the path. So that's why you are given 0 to 4, this is the path. So this is traversing from source node 0 to all other nodes. So now you can go with this particular concept. This is the explanation of Dijkstra's algorithm. The source and edges of the shortest path leading to them from source form a subtree T1 of the given subgraph. So shortest path, subtree T1. So this one is T1, this one is T2, this one is T3, and finally this one we consider it as T4. So Ti of given, so source and edges leading to them from source form a subtree. So next vertex nearest to source can be found among the vertices adjacent to vertices called as fringe vertices. Okay, so next vertex nearest to source. So can be found among the vertices adjacent to vertices of Ti called as fringe vertices. So which are the fringe vertices to node 1? So understand here what we call. So next vertex nearest to source can be found among vertices below or adjacent to vertices of Ti. So suppose Ti is 0, which are the fringe vertices of node T0? So fringe vertices of T0 is 1 and 7. So 1 and 7 are the fringe vertices. They are the candidates from which algorithm selects the next vertex nearest to source. So to identify ith nearest vertex, the algorithm computes for every fringe vertex U the sum of distance to nearest tree vertex V and the length D. So this is calculation of fringe vertex. To facilitate with the algorithm's operation, we label each vertex with two labels. The label D indicates the length of the shortest path from source to its vertex. So label D, here you can see, label D means distance from node to source vertex. So label D for node 1 is 4. Label D for node 2 is 12. Label D for node 7 is 8. The weight what we take, that we consider it as label D, the length of the shortest path from source to its vertex. The other label indicates the parent of the vertex. After we have identical vertex U to be added to the tree, we need to perform two operations. If you are adding a new vertex to the tree, so you should need to perform two operations. One, move U from the fringe to set of tree vertices. From fringe vertex, you move it to set of tree vertices. For each remaining fringe vertex U that is connected to U, so condition will be du plus w of U star comma U should be less than du. Okay, so du plus w of U star comma U should be less than du. So this is the formula we have. So this is the algorithm what we are taking. So this is very important example. So this is the illustration what we take. So consider you have to find the shortest path from A to E. So source vertex is A, destination vertex is E. So you have to find the path. So take A initially, A with hyphen comma 0 because it is a source vertex. So which are the remaining vertices? B, C, D, E. So B is reachable from A by A comma 3. So is C is reachable? So you should go with, is C is reachable directly from A? No. So C is, there is no edge from C to A. So minus comma infinity, come for D. So is D is directly reachable from A? Yes, A comma 7. E is not reachable. So in that, which is the minimum path? So B, A comma 3. 3 is there, 7 is there. So in that minimum one is 3. So mark A comma B here with 3. Now you take B. Okay, so which are the vertices visited? A is visited, B is visited. So now you find the condition to C, D and E. So A and B is already there. You have to go with C, D and E. So C will be taking, C is visited directly from B, but you have to go with source vertex. Which is the source vertex here? A. So from through for C, you have to take it. So B from B, C is visited through path 4. So you have to go with the source vertex 3 plus 4. So D is visited through B using 2. So you have to go with 3 plus 2. So that is 3 plus 2 because you have to find from A only. E is not visited through A or B. Okay, so in that, which is the smallest one you have? This one is 7, this one is 5. So go with 5. So D is reachable. Which are the remaining? C and E. So come for D. So D, B comma 5. So from D, so you have to go find the path for C as well as E. So for C, so C is reachable through D, but go for the cost. So 5 plus 7, now you have A, B, D. Okay, so now you have to find the path for C. So C is reachable through D, but go for the cost from A, it is 7 plus 5. Okay, so if you are going for C, so it is C, they have taken, it is. So you have to go for this path. So 3 plus 4, or you should go with 3 plus 2 plus 5, or you should go with 7 plus 5. There are three paths, 3 plus 4, 3 plus 2 plus 5, 7 plus 5. So in that, which is the minimum one you have? So either you go with 3 plus 4 or 3 plus 2 plus 5 or 7 plus 5. So which is the minimum one you have? So answer in the chat box. You have three paths from A to C, 3 plus 4, 3 plus 2 plus 5 and 7 plus 5. So in that, which is the minimum one we have? So minimum path is 3 plus 4. So that's why you have taken B comma 7. Understanding? So C is reachable through B comma 7. What is this B? It is an intermediate node. B comma 7. Come for E. So how the E is reachable? So you have to, now A, B, D is already there. So for E, you can go through 3 plus 5 plus 3 plus 2 plus 4, or you can go with 7 plus 4, or you can go with 3 plus 5 plus 4, 3 plus 2 plus 4, or 3 plus 4 plus 6. So in that, which is the minimum one? It is 3 plus 2 plus 5. So that's why you are taking 3 plus 2 plus 5 for E. That is 5 plus 4. Okay, so 5, 3 plus 2 is 5, 5 plus 4. Okay, so 7 is there, 9 is there, which is the minimum? C. So mark all the notes. So finally from C, you have to go with, from C, can you visit? So C is reachable using 3 plus 4 plus 6. So it's not the path, you go with D, E of D comma 5. So this is the finally visited nodes. So this is the problem we have solved. So shortest path from A to B. Here you can see A to B, it's 3. A to D, it's A plus A to B and B to D, length 5. And A to C, you can take it as A to B, B to C, that is 3 plus 4, 7. Next, A to E, you can take it as A to B, B to D, D to E. So of length 9. So that is example. Now you come for the Dijkstra's algorithm. So Dijkstra's algorithm for single show shortest path. So there is a graph which consisting of vertices and edges. So DV of the shortest path from S to V and vertex PV for every vertex. So initially distance vector will be infinity. Number of vertices will be null. Insert Q comma V comma DV. So if this is the algorithm what you have to go through. So if DU plus W of U comma U is less than DU. So now you write DU is equal to DU plus W of U star comma U, PU then U. So this is the algorithm what we are going for, Dijkstra's algorithm. Okay, so Dijkstra's that implementation. So we can see in this particular, initially DV. So node 0, B, C, everything will be under 0 only. So this algorithm has been applied here. So for vertex A, so same diagram. B is reachable through 3, D is reachable through 7. For vertex A comma B, so B 3, C 7, D 5. So this you have to go through. So now which is the minimum one you are having? It is B. So now you added A, B, D. So next you have 3, 7, 5, 9 that you have to do the operation. So when you go for A, B, C, D, this is the path. So this is the how the algorithm is going to work. So you can from A to B is 3, A to D is 7. Next after A, B, B is reachable with 3. So using A, B, C is reachable with 7, D is reachable with 5. So using A, B, D, so you have 3, 7, 5 with E as 9. Okay, I have written, you can go through this particular algorithm. So now you come for the analysis part. Analysis is big theta of length of V square for the graphs represented by their weighted matrix and the priority queue implemented as an unordered array. So as you all know, the Prim's Crystal, so Dijkstra's for the graph, it will be represented for graph as well as priority queue. It is implemented as an unordered array. For graphs represented by the adjacency list and the priority queue is minip. So as you all know, it is for Prim's algorithm, we have big O of E log V. So here also, it is similar to Prim's algorithm. So that's why you take it as big O of E log V. Okay, so you know, this is the homework what I will be giving. So kindly go through this particular algorithm. So, and understand the concept and solve this particular problem. So this is your homework. Homework we have given. So source no vertex is A. So which is the last vertex? It is L. Okay. So if you are there in the class, so understand this particular problem and solve it. I will give the same problem in your test. Okay. So kindly solve the problem and get the things ready. the same problem will be given in that test also. Okay, I am giving you the hint. So this problem will come for the second internals. Okay, so this is up to Dijkstra's algorithm. So I hope you all got understood. Kindly work and understand the concept, algorithm, work on that and solve the homework problem. Okay, so I hope you all got understood this particular problem. So any questions? So go through the video in the YouTube, my YouTube channel, 1DPMK. So kindly like, share, subscribe for the channel and get the knowledge of algorithms. Okay, so I ending this particular session now. So meet you up in the next class. So thank you all. Stay home, stay safe.